What is the true diagnosis of the apostate Amazon Synod? We present it not only from the human perspective, but from the perspective of God's Word. It is exactly described in the following God's statement.
The devil has come down to you, having great wrath, because he knows that he has a short time. Revelation 12:12.
God complains about idolatry in the temple.
He said to me, Son of man, do you see what they are doing?
In the Vatican Gardens and in other places in the Vatican.
The great abominations to make me go far away from my sanctuary. Ezekiel 8:6. I saw figures of all kinds, foul idols.
From Amazonia.
And there, between the porch and the altar, were about 25 men.
There were about 25 men, cardinals, at the Amazon Synod. They are under God's anathema, curse and excommunication, according to the Epistle to Galatians chapter 1, verses 8 and 9.
With their backs toward the temple of the Lord. Have you seen this, O Son of Man? Is it a trivial thing to commit the abominations which they commit here? Ezekiel 8:16-17.
What spirit rules in the church, and what spirit rules in the world today?
It is not the spirit of Christ, but the spirit of the world. It is the spirit of Antichrist. We are witnesses to global promotion of immorality connected with apostasy from God and from Christianity. It is a mass return to paganism and Satanism. Gender ideology, which says that a man is not a man and a woman is not a woman, is being enforced worldwide. This is a total loss of reason and conscience. The juvenile justice system, which steals children from their parents, is inextricably linked with gender ideology. Children are placed in so-called gay or paedophile foster families. Some are even victims of the sale of organs or ritual sacrifices.
Thank you.
The legalization of the stealing of children from families is promoted not only by the United Nations, but also by the Istanbul Convention. The Vatican is hypocritically silent on all this. The Vatican, however, not only does not defend children who are being morally devastated and stolen, but the pseudo-pope now directly promotes their moral devastation through so-called sexual education. He approved it during his flight from Panama. It is a serious crime against children and the gospel. The false pope is extremely active in driving non-Christian migrants to Europe with the aim of destroying Christianity. When the Lisbon Treaty abolished the Ten Commandments as the foundation of just legislation, the Vatican was silent on it. The words of the prophet Isaiah are true about the church prelates who voted at the Amazon Synod and thus opened the door to paganism. They are blind watchmen, dumb dogs. They cannot bark or defend God's laws. They are greedy dogs, which never have enough. They all look to their own way, everyone for his own gain, for his own career. Isaiah chapter 56. The pseudo-pope does not defend God's commandments, but rather destroys them in his papal documents, for example in Amoris Laetitia. 26 cardinals and 134 synodal bishops are in unity with him in the betrayal of Christ and the Church and have excluded themselves from the Church. At the 2018 Youth Synod, he included the term LGBT in the documents and thus gave it ecclesiastical approval. In February this year, instead of condemning the crimes of homosexual prelates and priests, as was demanded by the US bishops and public, he introduced so-called pastoral care for homosexuals under the label of accompaniment. When Archbishop Viganò warned about a homosexual network in the highest positions, as well as in seminaries, Bergoglio's Vatican swept it under the carpet. In June, the Vatican came up with the heretical document Instrumentum Laboris, taking the next step towards the destruction of the Church. Their evil agenda was confirmed at the Amazon Synod. It introduced the spirit of paganism along with magic rituals into the liturgy. They deliberately disguised it by causing chaos concerning the abolition of celibacy and the ordination of witches to deaconesses. These are crimes deserving the most severe punishments. Nevertheless, Bergoglio does not stop, because he knows that both Satan and he have a short time. See Revelation chapter 12.
What is the solution?
There is only one solution: true repentance. Archbishop Carlo Maria Viganò has offered resistance to the criminal system in the church. The Byzantine Catholic Patriarchate, by authority of the apostolic and prophetic office, has elected him in this extraordinary situation as the rightful Pope. Today, repentance for Catholics means to separate themselves from the heretic and apostate Bergoglio and to acknowledge the true Catholic and rightful successor of the Apostle Peter.